country people, Niger Delta people, Edo, listen to this madman in UK now. They can listen to it.
Do what we need to do. The protest is every day for the next 3 weeks. Every blessed day for the next 3 weeks. And you people must devise a strategy to outwit the army. As I said before, the army will face in one direction. There are some guns in Edo State right now as we speak. Use those guns to kill one or two or three army officers. Take their guns from them and begin to kill the others. Anyone you kill, you take the guns and you start, you kill other people as well. That's how it's going to be. Because they cannot sustain this fight for 3 weeks. Before 3 weeks, if they continue to move their troops down, Boko Haram will overrun the north.
Yes,
and they understand they are very stupid.
Okay,
you know that Janja will be very daft.
Okay.
Unless they are the ones sponsoring Boko Haram. There are guns in Edo State already. Kill the army wherever you see them. Kill one or two. Take their guns and
my brothers and sisters in the house, the man, the madman that is talking there, that is talking here, is in Adekano. He is from Abia State. I am from Edo State of Yedo Patakam. He is talking about my state. He is telling his people, telling his hypo-terrorist group that they have guns and weapons, other weapons in Edo, to kill military men, to kill policemen, to instigate trouble in my state, in Edo State. He is not from that state. He said he need Biafra. He should go back to his state, Abia State, to go and fight for Biafra. Not to instigate, not to cause tension, not to cause war in my state. Not to cause war in my state. You can be in Edo State buying guns, hiding it in our butches to attack policemen, to attack the military, so that they will declare war in Edo, so that they will be killing our youth. That will not happen. That can never happen. You know why? I will tell you. You see, in Benin, we have been living, the Igbos live there. We have no problem with them. Listen, this video is all about against the Igbos. We have no problem with the Igbos. We always say it. They are our brothers. I understand. But the Igbos have been living in our state. Go to forestry. Go to forestry. All the stuff there. Igbo owns everything there. We have about 20 to 25 streets in forestry. All the buildings there. They are doing their business there. We are patronizing them. We don't fight them. Go to New Benin, Benin City. Go to New Benin. Igbo owns everything there. They are selling their electronics there. Selling clothes. What are they doing their business there? They have been there now for over 50 years. We don't trouble them. But one thing is clear. You know, the Kanis Igbo man. When you attack police in Edo, when you attack military in Edo, it will affect the Igbos in Edo. That's it. That's how it works. We have to show to the military, to the government, that we are not in support. We are going, it will touch your people. It will affect your people. We will not say we will kill your people like you do. We are not stupid, but it will affect your people. If you want to fight for your Biafra, go to your five states, Southeast. Go and fight for your Biafra. You cannot be buying guns, hiding it in our butches, saying you want to attack the military, that you have some guns. And if you listen to him very well, he said, kill the military. Kill one or two or three military. And kill the rest as well. When you say the rest as well, you are talking about Edo, the masses in Edo. Or Edo's, in Edo, killing the Edo's. Try it and see. We will not tell you, try it and see. I want to bring this to the governor, our governor. Bring this to his notice. You have to address this issue right now. You saw what happened in Lagos. When in Adekano said, whenever his boy, we are doing our peaceful protest. It was so lovely. It was so peaceful. The whole world was talking about us. We want change in our country. This boy in Adekano had to send his own terrorist group threatening to kill Lagos State governor. Threatening to kill Tinubu. I don't like Tinubu. They are corrupt, I understand. But you know, they cannot have no right whatsoever to be sending his people, telling them to go and kill another man, go to another state that is not theirs, to say they should go and kill the governor there. No. If you want to fight, go to your state. Go to your land. The Yorubas have to, you know, they destroy the ancestors. The fight, it became Yorubas and Igbo, even not God intervention. The Igbos and Yoruba would have been fighting themselves in Lagos because of this reckless talk of Nnamdi Kanu. I think that is not enough. What are they doing in Oyibo now? They are telling you he placed 100 million on the heads of the governor there. If the governor of the state is not yours, you are from Abia State. If you want your Biafra, go and do it in Abia State. You can come to River State and be saying a city called Oyibo is no longer Oyibo, it's Obibo. It will not work. You kill Soja Man there, you were parading the street with his head. There is no way you will kill the military and the military will not strike back. There is no way you will kill military. Nobody does. You can't do that and go free. Nowhere in the world you can kill the military and they will come back for you. That is what is happening in River State. The people, the military, they are killing the terrorists there. They are not killing Igbos. Don't change the story. They are not killing the Igbos. They are killing the terrorists there. So, I support with them. I have no sympathy for these people they are killing. They are terrorists. Don't kill innocent people. Kill the terrorists. Now, I think that is not enough. Now you want to come and cause the problem, trouble in Edo State. Saying you have a gun in Edo that people should go and use it to kill military. Why can't you kill military when they came for you during their part of that? Why won't you? Why did you run away? You would have killed military there. Why can't you come back and kill military? Why are you you are in the faraway land, running your mouth, saying that you want to kill military in Edo? That would not work. If you try it, we will prove to these people. We will not let them, we'll tell the military, don't worry. It is the Igbos. It will affect your people. So, Igbo leaders, the governor in Igbo, in the southeast, you have to come out now. The first thing to do right now is to go to Nnamdi Kanu's father's house. We have to burn that house down to show to him there. You don't support this nonsense anymore. People, your people have been dying. Nobody has to die for Nnamdi Kanu. To come, you will stay there. How can you come to social media and be saying things like this? And you say you are not Boko Haram or you are not terrorists. You can be saying this the same time saying you are not a terrorist. These people are terrorists. What Nnamdi Kanu wants is simple. It's very clear. He wants social division. He wants war. You know he can't fight this thing. They are lily livered people. So what they want to do, Yoruba against the Edo. Edo against Urobo. Urobo against Shekiri. Shekiri against Ijon. Ijon against Ikwere. Ikwere against Efik. That's what they want. Ethnic trouble. Ethnic war. And they are not getting it. What he's doing now, he will come to one state, buy ammunition there, and begin to strike. You can't be using River State as a state where you launch attack. It can't happen. And you can do it in Edo as well. I am calling Edo State governor. You have to make this, let this be honest. I trust my Edo State youth. I trust my Edo people. Try it and see in Nnamdi Kanu. Then you will know. Hey, when I tell Baba. Hey, actually, you want your Biafra, go and get your Biafra. We are not the one to give you Biafra. You have been troubling us. Igbos, you guys have been troubling us. I'm not talking about the old Igbos. You know what I'm talking about. You have been troubling us, provoking us. You want to try power. You are in faraway land, running your mouth. When the army, you said they should go and kill army. And let you keep killing people. You keep killing people. You can't do it in our state. It will affect your people. It will affect them in forestry. Go to forestry. Who owns that place? It will affect them in New Benin. Yes, it will affect them. This fight is not about them, but it will affect them. That's how it works. I can tell you now, hey, Edo, all the Igbos in our state, they have to leave. We don't do that. But don't bring the trouble to Edo. Edo is Edo. Edo nile. Edo nile binu. Edo ni godo. Mi godo. Edo nevo ayire. Edo nevo zomo. In Nnamdi Kanu, there is no way. Your grave, you are heading, your head is near. The day you start calling other people out, that's the day you dug your grave. The grave of this your hypo-terrorist. I warn you people, now you are buying guns, adding it in our butchers. To cause trouble in Edo. Try it and see. We use your blood to cleanse the land. I'm telling you, try it. You think you want to do the rivers? I love Wike. but that one is small. Don't try those. We are there, those. The trouble what we do for Nigeria, don't do us. They are there, look we do our day. Look we not there, we not there. This is all you go. They are there, but they are there. Look we do our day. Look we not your day on our own. Don't let we do our own. Look we do our own. Look we do our own. Look we do our own.